KYPipe supports two different interfaces, the classic interface and the KYnetic interface. Now, with our Pipe 2020 release, we have added a collapsible ribbon menu to our KYnetic interface. KYnetic users now have the option of expanding this ribbon, which improves navigation by combining both icons and text in a more intuitive, tabbed structure. Pipe 2020 users should be running version 10 or later in order to access the ribbon. KYPipe issues releases every 2 years, which require a license upgrade, but versions are released continuously and apply to any license year. These versions contain bug fixes and occasionally minor improvements, such as added features. We recommend that users run the latest available version no matter which release they have. Versions can be downloaded and installed here. After loading the original KYnetic interface, we see the icons that make up the interface. But now we can use this button to expand the ribbon as we wish. The ribbon is also collapsible in case you want to go back to just seeing the icons. The ribbon tabs are located beneath the first toolbar, which we refer to as the main menu. They replace the KYnetic or secondary toolbar. Up above that, we've loaded these drop-down menus. This is the main menu from the classic interface. This classic main menu will appear in the Pipe 2020 KYnetic interface by default. This menu is helpful for those who want to see navigation options in drop-down format, or for those who have learned on the classic interface and wish to make the transition to the KYnetic interface. The items in the drop-down menus are also replicated within the KYnetic ribbon, as are all the options from the original KYnetic interface, usually with the same icons, although in a different organizational structure. Let's look at the ribbon now. We're in KYPipe, which has the largest number of tabs and submenus within its ribbon. The other analysis engines have fewer options, therefore we'll show KYPipe's ribbon. Regardless of the analysis engine you're using, you should see most of the menus available to you in this demonstration. First is the Map tab. Here we have our map navigation options, including zooming and panning, and selecting nodes and pipes in layout mode or group mode. If you know the name of a node or a pipe, but not its location, you can find it here, or search by address if you are using internet background maps. We also have the File menu within this tab, which allows users to load .p2k files, that is to say, the file that contains the model, save them, and reload without saving. We can save a specific view of the model with different pan zoom settings and load it again later. There is a Map Images submenu, which allows users to print to hard copy or to image files. Last, users can lock the model with one of these fixed mode buttons to prevent inadvertent editing of nodes and pipes. The next tab is the Settings tab, which contains global parameters that apply independent of the contents of the map area. The System Data menu has a thumbnail display here, which shows which analysis engine you're using, as well as global flow and pressure units. If we click on the thumbnail, we can see additional information, including the friction equation, the head loss factor, kinematic viscosity if we're using a liquid other than water, and the analysis variables used to determine if the program can achieve mathematical convergence. We also have additional unit information and simulation notes in the submenus. This is the Preferences submenu, which contains several different settings related to the system as a whole. Next is the Build Edit tab, which gives users the ability to create a model from scratch or to edit the system's physical components globally. You can import and export from here. This takes you to the data tables, which are a Microsoft Excel-like representation of the system, which can be edited on the back end. Users can create edits outside of KYPipe in a spreadsheet, such as Microsoft Excel, and then cut and paste into the data tables. This button allows batch creation of sprinkler system grids. You can perform final data entry checks, such as general error checking, and inspecting the system for connectivity and the presence of parallel pipes. There are edit functions once you've created or imported the system, including copy, cut, and paste functions. There is also a tool that snaps certain node types to existing pipes after they've been imported. You can move or scale the system from this submenu. Demands can be created and edited here. In KYPipe, some demands are associated with nodes, such as junction demands and metered connections, and some are associated with pipes, such as residential meters. So, while those functions are also available under their respective menus, demand inputs are also available here because demands are often applied and edited globally throughout the model. For instance, KYPipe's automatic demand distribution feature allows us to enter the total demands for an area, such as a city, and the software will distribute the demands to different pipes based on factors such as pipe diameter. This brings up the point that menu buttons are often found in more than one place within the ribbon. For instance, you can import and export modeling files within the Build Edit tab, but these features are also available in the Map tab under the File menu, which has been their historic location. This duplication allows users easier access to needed menus until they gain more experience with the ribbon-based interface, and allows experienced users added flexibility. Next is the Appearance tab. As the name implies, it allows you to make changes that affect the way you see the system. Note you can return to the map view by clicking this button, even if you have a menu already open. The exception is some menus that are legacy menus from the classic interface. For instance, Node Contours Emphasis. This menu requires you to use the X button in the upper right-hand corner of the menu to close it. KYPipe has several legacy features which we could upgrade for standardization and to take advantage of the faster computational speeds currently available to modern processors. But the advantage of retaining these features is that this way, .p2k files are and have always been backwards and forwards compatible among all our releases. This allows users to open .p2k files that were created as far back as our pre-year 2000 DOS interface in any release, up to and including Pipe 2020. In this submenu, we can add labels to pipes and nodes in the map area, including both input data and results data, and adjust the precision with which inputs and results are displayed. As stated, we can emphasize node parameters with contours in the map area, and display the same color coding for pipes as if they were nodes. The Colors and Sizes menu allows us to adjust the appearance of the pipes and nodes seen in the map area. We can alter their size, inner and outer color, and select from two-dimensional and three-dimensional representations. Background maps and internet background maps can be displayed here. We can find a given location at a different spot on the globe in case you want to start building your model there. We can show or hide different node types, which, due to their number, may dominate the display of our map area and prevent us from seeing or selecting other nodes and pipes. We can switch between a plan view and a profile view of the system, which is useful for things like checking our elevations. We can also show a grid with major and minor grid lines and snap our nodes to the grid if we wish. This last feature is the only function within this menu that's an editing function as well as a display function, since it actually affects the physical location of our nodes and thus our pipes if we tell the model to snap them to the grid. This last submenu allows us to add text nodes and push pins, display the north arrow, and customize cursor notations. The cursor notation is the pop-up box which we see when we hover over a pipe or node, displaying its input data and its output data if an analysis has been run. The Devices tab allows inputs for nodes that are more complicated than, say, a junction. Examples include pumps, tanks, hydrants, and active valves. You can also access the data tables from here in case you want to edit inputs for these devices on the back end. You can display pump curves from here and system curves after you run a system curve analysis. Although you need to set that up from a different tab, as we'll see in a minute. This is the Pipes tab, which controls pipe settings, including ways to edit pipe types across the system, including setting the material, diameter, reference roughness, and 10-year estimated roughness for your pipes. You can also change their appearance. Here we see the pipe emphasis menu and the colors and sizes menu again, which we saw earlier in the Appearance tab. We can scale pipes, and if we want to create duplicate pipes or orthogonalized pipes, we have those options. As we said, residential meters are considered to be part of a given pipe, not nodes in and of themselves. So we can input those here in this tab as well as within the Build Edit tab. Pipe fittings can be edited and minor losses set for new fittings within this menu. And pipe diameters can be optimized throughout the system using this tool. The next four tabs are color-coded light green to distinguish them from the others, since they allow us to set up and run different scenarios. Scenarios EPS is the first tab. Within it, the first submenu allows us to make changes to our model boundary conditions that can be applied for each case, for steady state scenarios, or for each time for extended period simulations. The next submenu only applies to extended period simulations. Here we can turn them on, set the duration of the simulation and the time step, as well as create control switches. For instance, if we want to turn a pump on to fill a tank based on a low water switching level within the tank, that's done here. This submenu allows automatic constraints to be created to keep the system within certain boundaries, as well as features that create sets of automatic pipe or node changes. Device parameter range analysis is a new feature for 2020 that allows you to set a range of input parameters for a device, say pump speed, and see the effects of those changes throughout the system without having to program the changes yourself. This menu lets you skeletonize the system, and if you want to save and load past analysis results, that's done here, which can be useful especially for large models with longer analysis times. We also have simulation memo information and customizable user information in this tab, as well as within the Map tab. Once our scenario parameters are set up, we next move to the Analyze tab, which is where we select the overall type of analysis. To do that, we go to the Analysis menu, where we can pick the analysis year if, say, we wish to introduce pipe aging, and we can select from any of our more specialized analysis types. Normally, KYPipe is set up to run in steady state, and as we saw, we can click inside a checkbox in the EPS menu to run an extended period simulation. But we have many other analysis types incorporated that are used by various industries and by municipal system operators. We can see that the save and load analysis results features are duplicated here. And in this next submenu, we see all the inputs necessary to run a system head curve analysis, including the button that runs the analysis, and finally, the button that displays the results, this last of which is a duplicate of the button within the Devices tab. We can also set up and analyze sprinklers, as well as perform a water quality and water age analysis. The last submenu allows rural analysis, which is especially useful for highly branched systems and or systems with a low connection density. The Facility Analysis tab contains shortcuts for the different analysis types often used by system operators. Some of these can also be accessed from within the Analyze tab, but they can be accessed here using fewer steps. We see the submenus for intrusions and pipe breaks, as well as defining pressure zones, travel time and travel path, travel distance, power cost, and hydrant analysis. There is also a hydrant flushing analysis, which returns flushing velocities based on the number and location of open hydrants, and these outputs can be compared to a user-specified minimum allowable velocity. The other analysis tab contains less frequently used options, although they can be very useful when they're needed. For instance, here we see our full system calibration tool, optimized pipe design and pump scheduling options, as well as the ability to run a temperature-dependent analysis. There's also this input which is applicable to low-pressure sewers. Last is the Reports tab. As we said, we can view the analysis results within the map area using options within the Appearance tab, but anything beyond that involving output data is located here. Perhaps most important is the analysis report. We can also take a system inventory, which lists all system components, including individual component and aggregate cost information, if cost data was entered. There is an automatic presentation generator, and we can create custom tables that can show the inputs and outputs for nodes and pipes by individual parameter. We can create profiles of the system, including animated profiles. These profiles can be saved outside of the .p2k file and reloaded as needed. We have a check valve animation feature, which shows the position of the check valve for pumps within the system at any given case or time within a KYPipe analysis. While it's helpful in KYPipe, this feature is especially useful for surge applications, since the position of the check valve can change rapidly, and displaying the check valve position allows us to diagnose a phenomenon known as check valve chatter. Another new feature for Pipe 2020 is this button, which calls up a list of keyboard shortcuts usable in any of our interfaces, allowing users to access different menus and settings without having to navigate to them. Within the configuration menu, we can do things such as turn off the classic main menu if we wish to, although many users prefer this menu visible. We can tell the software what to display, if anything, when we collapse the ribbon. The option would be to turn on the secondary toolbar buttons, which is the default setting for the KYNetic interface when the ribbon is not being used. We can control the size and location of the node info window and pipe info window as well. Scalable info windows can be used to display more information, which is especially useful when in group editing mode. Last, this button reloads the node info window or the pipe info window, depending on whether a node or a pipe was last selected. This can be useful if the window doesn't autofill, which sometimes can happen if you've navigated, pressed the analysis button, or changed menus.